Previously, on Mining to Hyperion, we set forth the rules to this series where we start with a single cobble block and have to progress all the way to Hyperion only using money made in mining lobbies. We've already hit Tier 7 Heart of the Mountain, and we've begun working towards a great mining set between our Sorrow Gear and our Gemstone Gauntlet. Let's see how much more we can do today. It's your boy Chips and welcome back, guys, to episode number 5 of Cobble to a Hyperion. Guys, we are about to go crazy, and you're not going to want to miss a single second of it, so be sure to stick around to the very end, and hopefully by then, we will have a Hyperion in our hands. But in order to get there's a lot of work that needs to get done, so let's throw on our gear, collect and eat up this cookie, and reset our HOTM tree so we can get things started. Now, as we fill in these tokens, we're gonna shoot up straight through the middle. And we're also gonna shoot to the left and up, as well as to the right and up. And we're gonna grab that mining speed boost. We grab powder buff for now because we do still need about 1 million more gemstone powder in order to fully max out a lot of our fortune. But halfway through the episode, I guess we'll reset again and exchange the powder buff for mining madness. Anyway, let's first go ahead and click as much as we can on these fortunes. There's Mining Fortune 2 up to 45, Fortunate completely maxed, Mining Fortune completely maxed, and then we can throw the last bit into Mining Speed and Professional. At this point, our tree isn't perfect, but it's decent enough. Also, before we get into anything too insane, let's go ahead and spend a little bit more money. We've got 37 mil on us. And if you don't know how I got this money or anything that I have already, you better go back and watch the previous episodes. Trust me, they're all fire. But we're going to go ahead and throw this money in the bazaar, actually, on oddities and recoms. Let's go ahead and place an order for 5 of them. 29 mil, beautiful. Now, as we wait for that to fill, we can jump on in and get the grind going. Since we did recently just buy a Bow Pet, we're going to want to put her to good use. So that means mining a ton of ruby gemstones. It should give me some pretty good money right off the bat. And of course, we're not just mining it anywhere. We've got a specific spot, some specific cords that we want to hit to do this. So I'll make my way over there, but as I'm doing that, I'm also going to try and complete some commissions. Not for HOTM XP, of course, but just for a little bit of XP, mining XP, so that we can level up our Bow Pet. So here we go, let's ruby mine for a couple hours and hopefully make some pretty money. And that's a GG on phase 1. So we've been selling a little bit as we've been mining, but now we can do the majority of it, starting with a yellow goblin egg, which has moved from the auction house to the bazaar, actually. So we can just go ahead and throw a sell offer up for 100k. Now, moving into the gemstone stack, our rubies are full and all this other stuff. We've got tons of topaz as well. We're going to go ahead and actually craft our ruby gemstones into some flawless. So let's do that with all of the ruby gemstones, even the ones in our sack. So that got me to 8 flawless ruby gemstones, and that combined with the other 8 flawless ruby gemstones, as well as the gold blocks that I've put in buy orders for, give me just enough materials to craft not only 1, but 2 gemstone gauntlets to sell. Now, I believe this is the best way to sell the ruby gemstones, as gemstone gauntlets go for about 20 million coins each. So let's go for 20.1 mil, and again, 20.1 mil. Hopefully, that's 40 million coins right there. And then in the topaz, which we also mined a lot, we've got 4 flawless that we can sell for 8.6 mil. And then we've got a few other gemstones that we've just been accumulating over time. So we can throw up the amethyst for 2.1 mil, the sapphire for 1.6 mil, and the jade for 2 mil. Now, the gemstones are probably going to take a little while to all go through, but we do have about 10 million coins worth to claim, and we have both of our gemstone gauntlets to claim as well, putting our purse up to 63.5 million coins. With this money, we're going to go ahead and buy 4 jaderolds. They're about 7.5 mil each, and they're going to give my gear a beautiful fortune upgrade. It's going to be plus 25 on each piece, so with 4 of them, we just added 100 fortune, and then we can throw those recoms on that we bought earlier to make it even higher. Dang, look at that gear. Then with our remaining 32 mil, we can grab up a mineral talisman, as well as a jungle amulet. We can grab up some flawless amber gemstones and replace the fine ones on our gear. our ring of power, and our gauntlet. There we go. Speaking of our gauntlet, I meant to actually go ahead and recom it earlier, so let's do that. And that should be pretty good for now, so back to the mines we go. We still need to make about 100 mil in order to buy our final few upgrades. So, wow, boys, a lot of time has passed, and a lot of mining has been done. As we've been grinding at this stage, we've been able to make about 8 mil per hour from Jasper, and about 7 mil per hour from Ruby and Jade. Now, don't get me wrong, that's some pretty decent money. It's better than farming, but it's not as good as it can be when it comes to mining. Since we're planning on mining all the way to a Hyperion, I think it's going to be worth it to spend a little bit of money and improve that hourly profit. So here we go, let's head to the hub. Now in terms of money, I actually have no idea how much we've just made, but we can sell a little bit of hard stone. We can grab all these fine jade gemstones to throw in the bazaar. That's 27 mil, plus the bit of jade that we've gotten here, which will give me another 5 mil. Then there's the jasper. We've got one flawless to throw up for 4 mil, and a bit of fine to throw up for another 4 mil. And then we can move on to our topaz gemstones for 2 plus 4.5 mil. And finally, we come to our ruby gemstones. I still think the best way to sell these are beautiful gemstone gauntlets. So, I mean, there's one right there. And then we'll throw a buy order in for about 32 more gold blocks, just like so. And while we wait for that, we actually have one more thing to sell. So if we head up these stairs, we can talk to George and toss in the legendary rock, which we finally got by hitting that final ore milestone. Kind of OP because it's a free 10 million coins. There we go. So in terms of gauntlets, we can go ahead and craft our second. Then we can store some of this excess because I'm sure we'll need it later. And we can throw these two gauntlets up for 19.6 mil. That was one. And here, my boys, 19.6 mil is two. Holy, we have a lot of money coming in. There's 26 mil in the bazaar. So we can start here. Moving on to the auction house, we can go ahead and claim up both of these beautiful gemstone gauntlets for a ridiculous amount of money. And guys, we're over 110 million coins in the purse. Now just back to the bazaar so we can spend it. We want to go ahead and grab 5 perfect jade gemstones for 60 million coins. And then I'm going to need to claim a tiny bit more to put up my very final buy order of 5 perfect topaz gemstones. Oh, we're so close. 5 perfect topaz gemstones. It's hard for buy orders of perfect gemstones to fill, but I really hope they do, because just those tiny improvements to pristine and fortune will make a massive difference. Caught some Z's, and here we are the next day with 2 full bazaar orders. That's the 2 we already claimed, plus 3 more perfect topazes, and 5 perfect jades. This is beautiful, boys. It's enough to fill all of my armor as well as my pickaxe. So let's take off the flawless. Bang, bang. It's gonna double my fortune on every piece, and it's gonna add an extra point for pristine to every piece. So there is all of my armor, and here we are with the gauntlet. Stats aren't looking too bad, but before we get into mining, we're going to do one more thing to get them even higher, and that's going to be yet again resetting our Heart of the Mountain. Again, we're going to shoot straight up the middle, but this time we're not going to get powder buff, so instead we're just going to go to the right for the mining fortune, to the left for the mining speed, and across the middle over to mining madness, and a bottom across to the mining speed boost. Now again, we're gonna max out mining fortune 1 all the way to level 50. Then we're gonna go ahead and max out fortunate with some more mithril powder. And once that is level 20, we can throw the rest of our mithril powder on the mining speed, as well as seasoned mine men. As we dive into the gemstone powder, we're gonna wanna max out mining fortune 2. Level 50 is right there, with about 178 to spare and throw onto mining speed as well as professional. Guys, I think we are good to go. The only improvements from now on are going to come as we level up our mining skill. That's going to be an extra 4 fortune per level. But here we go, boys. Let's jump on in. And I don't even know what we're going to mine. It's probably going to be a complete mix of everything from like jade to ruby to jasper when I can find it, to even armadillo mining. So tons more time has passed and a little bit more mining has been done. I really do apologize that this video is taking forever to get out, because honestly, I've just been kind of traveling a little bit. But we're back and we're on the grind and we're not going to stop until that sword is in my hand. Progress has been made though, so let's hop out of here and let's claim up this perfect jade gemstone that we bought, because I actually remembered one more improvement that I can do, and that has to do with the ring of power. So we can take the fine jade gemstone out of that guy and replace it with a perfect one. So that was actually another fortune upgrade. Now in terms of money, I haven't tracked the updated hourly profit just yet, but I do have some stuff to sell. Right here in my second ender chest, I've got some flawless ruby gemstones as well as some gold blocks. So with the rest of the gold blocks that I just put a buy order in for, we can craft two gemstone gauntlets to go ahead and sell. Looks like they're still going for about 20 million coins. So let's do just that. On top of the 40 mil I'm making right there off of ruby, I've also got some fine jasper to sell. Although it's not nearly as much quantity wise, it sells for a lot higher price. So that's going to be another 28 million coins. And lastly, the other thing I've been mining is jade, and I've got a lot of this stuff. So let's go ahead and throw it in as the fine type for 36 mil for the first inventory, and then we've got another 24 mil to go in on top of that. And then on the side, I actually have, you know, just your usual hardstone money, but I also tried mining gold for a second just to see what it would be like. Threw in a couple orders here and didn't stick with it, but I made a little bit of money from it. Mining that gold was on track for about 8 mil an hour, which is better than farming, so I mean, I guess it's an option. And then we also have just like a mil worth of random automaton parts that we can just claim quickly. But hey, when all that stuff I just put up sells, we should be at about 120 mil, which I think is like a fifth of all the way there. So it's decent. It's decent. But anyway, back into the mines. About 500 or 600 mil still to go. We've been on the grind and we just hit mining level 50. That is four more fortune for me to mine with and a pretty cool milestone as well.
Boys.
A few days later and I am actually all the way onto mining level 52 now. And I got all the way from 50 to 52 just by mining gemstones, which basically means that I mined a lot of them. So let's go ahead and sell. Starting off with rubies, if I go ahead and craft one more flawless, then I can claim the six flawless in my gemstone sack and grab 64 flawless from my ender chest. And then we can start crafting and we can do a lot of damage here because we can make 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 gemstone gauntlets to sell, bro. Oh my gosh. At about 20 mil each, that's almost 200 million coins right here. So let's throw them up. In terms of jade, we got this whole ender chest page as well as the next one. Again, I mean, I don't really know if selling this stuff as fine is really the most efficient way to go or best way to go, but it kind of works because we have about 150 million coins worth of it up right now. I guess you could say that's kind of a lot. Moving on, we've got a tiny bit of topaz to claim and sell for about 13.8 mil. And finally, I've got a bit of jasper to claim and sell for about 26 mil. So we're racking in some pretty good money. If you want to talk hard stuff, stats, I'm racking in about 12 mil an hour. Everything hasn't sold just yet, but when it does, I'll be at just about 500 million coins, and this is at about 220 hours into the series. Now, although 500 mil is a ton of money, unfortunately, it's not enough for the beautiful Hyperion, because thanks to all of those dupers, the lowest priced Hyperion on the AH now is almost 900 million coins. It's about 300 mil more than I expected it would be, and about 200 mil more than the cheapest Terminator even. So it's a hefty price, and it's going to require a lot more grinding. Quick plug, sub. I have so many hours in the mines, and this is my first time running into the Golden Drag spawn place. It's pretty dope. And check it out, boys. Mining level 55 was just hit. And so I think it's about time we do another round of selling. First off, let's hit the bazaar and just throw some spare ruby in here, along with a little bit of hardstone. Then we can hit the storage once again and kick it off with our ruby. With this 18 and the 6 in here, we can go ahead and craft 3 gemstone gauntlets. These have been fluctuating in price a lot recently, but looks like 19.1 is the price to sell them for right now. And with Fluffy purchasing our gemstone gauntlet right here, we can claim them all up, and yeah, we have a little bit more than three to claim. I only put three in just now, but we've been grinding Ruby for a long time. I've been putting in hella hours these past few days. So this right here is 8 auctions that I can claim for 160 million coins. Dang, boys, that's beautiful. And I forgot, but I do actually have one more gauntlet to sell. So let's do that one for another 19.1. What can I say, man? My bow pet has been doing wonders. Pushing forward, though, we can claim that up and grab some jasper, amethyst, sapphire, topaz, and amber to throw in the bazaar for 27 mil, 2 mil, 7.3 mil, 3.5 mil, and 1.2 mil. Then we can start heading into our storage once again and taking out all of our fine jade gemstones, our 2 e-chest pages full, and moving them from there into the bazaar for about 37 million coins in inventory. I mean, we're still in the process of selling these gemstones, but guys, we're up to 750 mil in the purse already. Just 100 mil to go for the series to be complete. So come on, lads, buy up my gemstones. In fact, I think I'm selling so many jade gemstones that I've caused the price to drop below the NPC price. As you can see, I'm selling for 25.599 here, and the NPC price is 25.6. So let's just dump them all in there. Why not? Here we go, boys. That's 800 mil already. Here's another inventory into the trade menu. And finally, the last canceled bazaar offer getting thrown into the trade menu, leaving me at a beautiful 870 million coins. Oh, boys, we are there. You have no idea how excited I am. I'm going to buy this Hyperion. I'm going to do it right now. But first, can we just talk about how crazy this series was? I have 870 million coins in my purse right now. I've got a full level 100 bow pet and armadillo pet. I've got a beautiful mining setup in my jaded mythic sorrow set with some perfect gemstones on them, as well as my auspicious gemstone gauntlet with perfect gemstones. And I got all the way up to mining level 55, dude. Holy. So boys, it is time to do the deed. Mr. Auction Master, if you would be so kind as to sell me your cheapest Hyperion. 848 million coins, boys. We're about to do it. Hit that like button and subscribe because this is everything we've been working towards for the past couple of months, and it's in our hand right now. Oh my gosh. I just look so beautiful with the Hyperion in hand, the bow pet. I got the beautiful new cloak on my back and a massive smile across my face, dude. I've been working on this series forever, and this final episode alone has taken me a whole month. If we want to talk numbers real quick, here are my final stats at the end of the series. I was making about 13 to 14 mil an hour. It was tough to tell because the prices were fluctuating so much due to the bazaar going down and up. Then getting into time played, farming took 320 hours to go from nothing to 600 million coins and buy that Hyperion. And for mining, I can take the 479 hours that I had at the beginning of the series and subtract it from my current playtime of 447 hours, and that would give me 268 hours. That is how long it took me to go from nothing to a Hyperion from just mining, which is, of course, the most important statistic I can say. Guys, we went from one single piece of cobblestone to one entire Hyperion, one of the best weapons in the game, and it costed me about 850 million coins. Now, sweet, you have a Hyperion, but bro, you are cata zero. What are you doing with it? Well, boys, I'm giving it to you guys. If you have seen this whole series, I really do appreciate it, and I'm showing you how much I appreciate it with this giveaway. So if you guys want a chance to win the Hyperion, it's going to be similar to last time. All you have to do is like the video, hit that subscribe button and comment your IGN down below. All of this is free to do, so just go ahead and do those three tasks, like, subscribe, and comment your IGN, and you will have a chance at a free 850 million coin sword. This video should basically have as many likes and comments as it has views, because there's no reason not to do this. Anyway, it is time to bring this beautiful series to a close. Once again, thank you all so much for your support recently. We're almost at 50k subs, which is insane. Absolutely blows my mind. Anyway, I wish you all a beautiful end of the semester, end of the year. Happy holidays as all this stuff is coming up. And I hope to see you all in my next adventure. But that is going to do it. Adios and goodbye.